Hi guys! Today, ChargerLAB will disassemble the Baseus 100W GaN II Fast Charger with QC5 protocol, the world's first QC5 100W GaN charger. At the same time, the charger is also compatible with QC2 and QC3 and other protocols. Then, we'll see each part of this new QC5 Fast Charger. If you think our video is helpful, please subscribe to our channel for more content. Firstly, it's the appearance. This charger's white shell adopts flame-retardant PC. Most of the surface is matte, and the upper and lower edges are smooth. The USB-C port is at the bottom, and we can see the Baseus brand logo and QC5 logo. Besides, the plastic insertion is red-orange. A huge 100W is printed on the side. There's an LED inductor in the upper right corner. The input is equipped with foldable pins, which is easy to carry. Let's see the specification of the charger. Model is CCGAN100CC. It supports wild voltage input of 100 to 240 volts and output of 5 volts, 12 volts, 3 amp, and 9 volts, 15 volts, 20 volts, 5 amp. Let's see the size of the charger. Length, width, and height are 67, 55, and 30 mm. The weight is 174 grams. Compared with Apple 96 watts charger, it's still smaller. Use ChargerLab powered ZKT002 to test the protocol. We can see it supports the mainstream fast charging protocol as well as the QC5 that is actually supported but not shown. It also supports 5 fixed PDOs of 5 volts, 3 amp, 9 volts, 3 amp, 12 volts, 3 amp, 15 volts, 3 amp, 20 volts, 5 amp, and a set of PPS PDOs of 3.3 to 20 volts, 5 amp. Okay, next let's go ahead to tear it down. After opening the shell, we can see the pins and the PCB are connected through the cable. The PCBA module is wrapped with black copper to dissipate heat. The heatsink is fixed by a clip. There is also a thermal pad on the back of the PCB. Those components on the front PCB are fixed by the thermal adhesive used for heat dissipation. After cleaning up, we can see both input and output parts have small boards. The four electrolytic capacitors for high voltage filtering are in the middle. The upper side of the PCB spec is the synchronous rectifier and an optocoupler. As for the middle part, it has PFC boost controller, boost switching transistor, PWM controller, and high voltage switching transistor. A rectifier bridge is at the bottom. ChargerLab found this charger uses APF boost circuit to power the flyback switching power supply, and then adopts the protocol chip to control the wide range output voltage. Next, let's start from the bottom side to analyze every single component one by one. The left side welded a small vertical board, and the right side has two film capacitors and filter inductors. Remove the small board. There are a fuse, common mode troche, and X capacitor on it. The specification of time delay fuse is 3.15 amp, 250 volts. Wire-wound common mode troche is used to filter out EMI interference. Here's another common mode troche. The capacity of safety X capacitor is 0.68 microfarad. This is a rectifier bridge from World. And with send voltage of those two CBB film capacitors is 450 volts. This is the filter inductor and the PFC boost inductor is next to it. There is certain space between the electrolytic capacitor for high voltage filtering and the small board of output. A transformer is on the other side, and the mini electrolytic capacitor has an insulation tube outside. PFC boost controller comes from OS Semiconductor NCP1622BEC, which is based on an innovative, fairly synchronous frequency foldback method. PFC boost switching transistor adopts Navitas NV6125 GaN power chip, which adopts QFN 6x8mm package with enhanced heat dissipation. It is suitable for step-up, step-down, half-bridge, full-bridge switching power supply, etc. There are three parallel 330 milliohm resistors used for PFC current detection. This is the PFC boost inductor, and the specification of four electrolytic capacitors for high voltage filtering is 450 volts, 22 microfarad. The specification of the master control chip's power supply capacitor is 100 volts, 10 microfarad. The master control chip of switching power supply comes from OS Semiconductor NCP1342, which is a high-frequency primary PWM controller. It integrates X2 capacitor discharge capability and multiple protective functions. Its standby power consumption is also ultra-low. The high-voltage switching MOSFET comes from Oriental OSG65R200J, packaged by PDFN8×8, with standard voltage 700 volts and resistance is 200 milliohm. This is the charger's transformer, and we can see two solid capacitors are on this side. As for this empty space, two SMDY capacitors and synchronous rectifier controller are in here. And there are two optocouplers and two synchronous rectifiers are on the corresponding area of PCB spec. Two optocouplers cross the primary and secondary circuit used for primary and secondary communication, output voltage regulation, and protection function. Two SMDY capacitors come from TRX. They are very suitable for GaN fast chargers because of the small size and lightweight. The secondary synchronous rectifier controller comes from ZMJ Semiconductor, model is MK91808. It's very compact and suitable for flyback topology architecture. It also uses self-power technology with independent intellectual property rights to power VCC and can be directly placed on the front. Two synchronous rectifiers are from Hunteck. The specification of two solid capacitors for output filtering is 25 volts, 560 microfarad. An LED inductor is in here. The components of output small board are mainly on the front. We can see the protocol chip, output VBUS switching transistor and thermistor. This little black one is thermistor, used to detect the temperature inside the charger. Protocol chip comes from Injoinic IP2726S. It got Qualcomm's first QC5 certification in the world and is designed for the latest fast charging technology which can support more than 100 watts. At the same time, it has extremely high reliability and integration, which can effectively reduce the size of the chip and cost. The output VBUS switching transistor adopts ZMJ ZM027N03N, packaged by DFN5×6. With standard voltage is 30 volts and resistance is 2.7 milliohm. Well, that will be all components of this charger. The layout of the components on the PCB module is neat and compact. There are lots of thermal adhesives between each component for heat dissipation. The most critical chip is the high-performance protocol chip with QC5 certification, which can prepare for future needs. If you are preparing to buy a smartphone that supports QC5, you can definitely consider this charger. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe to us. And you can also visit our official website, ChargerLab.com. See you next time. Bye!